Hi everybody, I hope you're well. Today we'll take a look at the GA Residential Masterpieces issue number 3 devoted to Villa d'Ava and Maison à Bordeaux by OMA. Villa d'Ava stands on a hill amid a residential zone in Saint-Claude, a commune in the suburbs of Paris. Average in size compared to other lots in the vicinity, the site is bounded by the front row and the neighboring lots on both sides. It is narrow in shape with a short frontage on the road. The program involves a residence for an average family of three, comprised of a couple and a child. The client asked for a relatively simple program, requiring two bedrooms for the couple and the child, and a living room as a common space. The rooftop swimming pool is the only element of particularity in the program for this house. The basic layout of the house is a simple one, like a straight transcription of relationships between elements in the program. Volumes housing two bedrooms are placed on both sides of the volume, accommodating the living room and the swimming pool at an angle. A concrete wall pierces through the center of the site along the living room volume, dividing the site in two while creating ramps that service the main flow lines. One of the slopes is a driveway leading down to the garage placed under the master bedroom volume on the north side of the wall, and the other is a sloping garden that crosses through the south side of the site. Such contrast is certainly suggestive of the state of conflict and the boundary between two elements that are present on this suburban site, the city and the countryside. A gate opened in the boundary wall facing the road leads to a curved approach through a forest of steel columns up to the entrance. This random wilderness of columns constitutes the pilotis that supports the child's bedroom volume above. The columns are colored in different tones in order to add a visual depth to the garden in the back. The silver volume on top and the copper-hued master bedroom volume, which can be partly seen across the garden, are clad with corrugated aluminium sheets of different colors and are placed parallel to the road. The volume perpendicular to the bedroom volumes is given a public character, accommodating the living and dining rooms. It is a glass box resting on a stone-covered platform as an expression of openness and lightness, keeping the aluminium boxes on its both ends afloat in the air. The entrance hall is a double-height space which serves as a starting point of the stairs and slopes that lead to various rooms within the house. The northern slope runs between the aforementioned white concrete wall and the plywood wall of rough grain texture to provide access to the living room on the west side of the upper level facing the garden. On the other hand, the steel spiral staircase with an airy, sculpturesque form climbs up to the living room level and to the child's bedroom farther up. On garden level, the southern wall, composed of such textures as frosted glass and transparent glass equipped with bamboo and punched metal screens and curtains inside, is a filter offering variation to the panoramic view of the garden that stretches along the longer side of the single space room. This single-space volume leading to the living room at the western end accommodates the dining room and the kitchen. Sitting behind the softly curved wall of translucent corrugated polycarbonate sheet is a luminous kitchen with a skylight. It is located on the north side so that it does not obstruct the view through the approach from the entrance to the living and dining rooms. These spaces are integrated to one another by means of the solid terrazzo finish on the floor. Randomly holed texture and opaque finish are arranged alternately to cover the ceiling, adding rhythm and character to each zone. At the western end, on garden level, the living room is a space with a feeling of openness surrounded by glass walls on three sides. Its location, most distant from the road, ensures the family's privacy and provides a countryside living opportunity in the lush greenery. On the south side of the living room, within the gap between the living room and the bedroom volume above, is a set of external flip-up stairs leading up to the rooftop terrace that reminds of the mechanical stairs at Pierre Charot's Maison de Verre, a masterpiece of modern architecture. The bedrooms for the couple and for the child share the terrace above the living room. The two volumes are shifted in opposite directions, north and south, in order to ensure a clear view to the garden as well as privacy in each room. The eastern terrace, planted with turf, features a protective construction fence in vivid orange plastic, while the western terrace is finished differently with steel fence and resin flooring for industrial use. A swimming pool is placed between these terraces overlooking the Eiffel Tower, a Parisian landmark to the east behind the forest of Boulogne, so that the residents would swim toward Paris. Reminiscent of the pool crossing the Atlantic in a drawing by Kohlhaas for his Story of the Pool, 1977, the swimmer would float in the night sky toward the Eiffel Tower. The photographs and text are by Yukio Futagawa. Ask for the book at your local bookstore. Thank you for joining me today and see you in the next video. Bye!